Hello guys, continue with the company incorporated outside India, that is a foreign company. We last time we dealt with the section 380, that is documents to be delivered to registrar by foreign company. That has to be delivered within 30 days from the establishment date to the registrar in FC, in form FC1. Okay, what are the documents? First one, certified copy of charter, statutes or memorandum and articles or any other instruments not defines constitutes that defines the constitutes of the company. That should be in the English language. If it is not English language, that should be translated to the English languages by the certified and authenticated by the person. That once asked in the examination, who authenticated that translation from the local language to the English language, that we'll see later on. Next comes full address and registered or principal office, that has to be documented and given to the registrar. List of directors and secretary of the company, directors and secretary of company, name and address of person resident in India who authorizes to receive the notice from the registrar or a service or process from the registrar. That has to be given, name and address. Next, full address of the deemed to be place of principal place of company in India. That has to be given. What is about the number two? That is a registered or a principal office, that can be in foreign company. Fifth point, full address that deemed to be place principal office of company in India. Sixth, particulars of opening or closing place of business in India, earlier occasions. If they started before, when they opened or when they closed the place of business, if any. Next comes a declaration that none of the directors are convicted, has been convicted or debarred from the to form the company and they manage the company in India or in abroad. That has to be declared. These are the 7 points has to be documented and given to the registrar within 30 days of the date of establishment. Where to be delivered? Registrar having jurisdiction over New Delhi. This is asked in the examination and it can be probable question, MCQ question. So where to be delivered? Registrar having jurisdiction over New Delhi. Yes, example, this is with regard to the translation of the language from local language to the English language. There is a Chinese company, they wanted to establish one company in India that will be known as a foreign company. As per section 380, memorandum has to be given. If it is in a local language, translation has to be given. So that memorandum is in local language, that has to be translated. Who will translate? The question is authentication of this translation. Who will authenticate? So for that answer is, we have to go to the rule. Rule mentioned 2 points. First rule is, you should be in certificate should be in English language. If it is not in English language, that has to be translated by certified, authenticated in a English language. By point number B, authenticated by the advocate, attorney or a pleader entitled to appear before High Court of India. He can authenticate. Advocate, attorney or a pleader entitled to appear before the High Court of India, or it can be affidavit. Affidavit can be given by the concerned person who has the knowledge of both local language and the English language. He can affidavit. Next question, documents. If documents are not delivered to the registrar within 30 days, what is the consequences? There is a section in 392. This is for all the contraventions, not only for section 380. 392 contraventions of the foreign company provisions. So that tells for the company as well as the officer in default. In case of a company, fine is 1 lakh to 3 lakh. Additional fine also is there, 50,000 per day if their default continues. for the officer in default, imprisonment up to 6 months or fine 25k to 500k, that is 5 lakh or both. So company 1 lakh to 3 lakh, officer in default to 25,000 to 5 lakh. If it is a additional continuous default, additional fine of 50,000 per day that continues, officer in default imprisonment up to 6 month. So that is as per section 392. We will move on to section 381, that is accounts of a foreign company. Accounts, that comes balance sheet, P&L, P&L account. The first point is, as per section 381, balance sheet, P&L account should be given a certified copy. First they have to maintain and prepare, and that certified copy has to given to the registrar within 6 months of the closure of the financial year of that particular foreign company. Closure of financial year within 6 months, all the documents, okay, whatever, not only other documents also required. And second point is, foreign company should send all the business establishment in India address, name and address, all the establishment, for example in West Bengal, Bangalore, Delhi, all the establishment should be business establishment in India, place of business should be given to the details, should be given to the registrar. And comes third point is with the rules. It has 3 points. First one is a financial statement should be prepared as per schedule 3 of the Companies Act. Next, it should include a statement of related party transaction. It should include a statement of repatriation of profit, and it should include a statement of transfer of funds, that includes dividend also. So 3 points: statement of related party transaction, repatriation and transfer of funds. And within 6 months, the rule says within 6 months of close of financial year of the foreign company should be delivered. And third point is, in the rules is audit section, as per if foreign company maintain section 381.11, the accounts are maintained in that, then audit has to be done by the auditor, that is CA in practice. It can be sole proprietor firm or LLP firm. This is as accounts of the foreign company. Next comes section 382, display name of the company. Every branch or every place of business outside of place of business, foreign company has to write down or dispatch or display or exhibit name of the company, that is X Limited in this case, and where it is, which country it is incorporated, for example USA, that has to be written outside or exhibit outside the place of business, name of the company and the country where it is incorporated. Number point with regard to display of name of company, a foreign company, is legitimate English character has to be entered, legible English character has to be entered, that with again with regard to the name of the company and the country where it is incorporated, that is to should be entered in the bill head, business letter paper, etc. Bill head, business letter paper, etc. And the liabilities of members, and this has to be entered everywhere. Liabilities of members are limited, has to be entered everywhere, even in the bill held, business letter paper, liabilities of members limited. So these are the 3 points with regard to section 382, display name of the company. Moving on to next section, section 383, service on foreign company. Any process or notice or any other document required to be served to foreign company. What do you mean by that? For example, registrar. Want to give X foreign company. X Limited is a foreign company. Registrar wants to give, needs to give notice to the X foreign limited, X Limited, that is a foreign company. How can he give? So that is what section 383 says. Any process notice or any other document required to be served to foreign company, it will be deemed to be sufficiently served. So that is will be called as served. It is enough if it is given to the person whose name is mentioned and address is mentioned in the section 380. So we see in section 380, one person has to give his name. Correct. Point number 4, name and address of person resident in India who is authorized to receive the notice and service process. That same person will be given the notice or process or any other documents required to be served. He will receive it as mentioned, the name mentioned in section 380. He will receive by post or a electronic mode, or just left at his address. That is sufficiently enough that it is deemed to be received. Moving on to next provision, section 386, with regard to the interpretation, how we can interpret the certain expression in the this foreign company expression. We have three interpretations with regard to the expression: certify, director, place of business. Certified means certified in a prescribed manner to be a true copy or a correct in with regard to the translation. I given Chinese local language exam, Chinese company, that translation has to be a certified in a prescribed manner to be a true copy or a correct translation. Second one is a director. Who is a director? Any person whose direction or instruction, to the board of director accustomed to act. So he has a control. You can say he has a control over board of direction. Third is, what is a place of business? It includes share transfer or registered office. This is asked in the one of the exam. So it is there in practice manual. So place of business includes share transfer or registered office. We see in section 386, before section 383 service on foreign company, section 386 interpretation, we missed section 384. Section 384 with regard to the debenture, annual return, registration charges, books of account and their inspection. It is same like whatever it is applicable to section 71 to the debentures, it will applicable to foreign company with mutatis mutandis, MM. That is what, once the necessary changes have been made, that provision can be applicable. Mutatis mutandis. Annual return, section 92 shall be followed, same as the normal annual return. That is the filing of the annual return, first preparation of the annual return and the filing of the annual return dealt in the section 92, you know, IPCC. That is same will be applicable. Mutatis mutandis. Registration charges with regard to the properties, chapter 6 will be applicable. Books of account inspection, chapter 14 will be applicable. As incorporated in India, it will be applicable same as to foreign company. But the one important point is amendment with regard to this one here. Of course, of a modification required, modification alteration is required as per foreign company with regard to section 92. You cannot apply all the section 92. Required modification can be done, but amendment is with regard to the CSR. Section 135 will be applicable. So this is one of the amendment. So MCQ question is possible, very much possible in this case. So remember section 384, preparation and filing of the annual return as per section 92 after certain modification, but CSR section 135 will be applicable to foreign company. Moving on to the next provision, section 387, dating of prospectus and particulars. You know, prospectus, before the issue of the shares or IPO, you have to give, company has to give prospectus to the stakeholders. So in that, they have, prospectus has to be dated and signed. That is the first thing, and it includes the matters that should include instrument on which constituted or defining the constitution of the company. Instrument has to be there. Second point, enactment and provision, on which enactment or which provision, under which provision the company has established, that enactment and provision has to be given. C, address in India with regard to the instrument and the enactment, where registrar can inspect it, that address has to be given. That is a C. D is a date and country where such company is incorporated, foreign company, head office incorporated. So first thing is the instrument, second one enactment or provision, third one address in India with regard to the inspection of the instrument and enactment. D is the date and country where the country company is incorporated or registered. Last one is a D, address of the principal office. If the company is established the business, if yes, address of the principal office has to be given. But the thing is, ABC, A, comma B and C will not applicable. That is, instrument, enactment and address in India with regard to the inspection will not be applicable if the prospectus issued more than 2 years. The commencement happened after 2 years, issued for the more than 2 years, A, B, C will not be applicable. Only D and E will be applicable. No need to enter in the prospectus A, B, C. Moving on to next provision, section 388, expert's consent. When the foreign company wants to issue the prospectus to the stakeholders or the shareholders with regard to the share subscription, they cannot issue prospectus without expert's consent. So thing is, expert consent is must or a mandatory for the issue of the prospectus. Moving on to next section, section 389, registration of prospectus. So prospectus has to be registered with the ROC, correct? Let's suppose it is a prospectus, it should be registered with the ROC. But what are the conditions for the prospectus, whether any other documents to be included in that? So this all dealt in the section 389, registration of a prospectus. No prospectus can be issued without certified by the chairperson and two other directors. So no prospectus issued without certified by the chairperson and, very important, and two other director. So MCQ probable question here. And registration also, that should be registered with the ROC, register with the ROC with the documents relating to the consent of the expert should be there, as we seen before. That is a section 388, consent of the expert should be there. Contract of a managing director or manager or other material contracts entered within 2 years, that should be given, that documents should be given, and the underwriting agreement also should be given, and the POA, power of attorney. Moving on to next section, section 390, with regard to IDR, Indian Depositary Receipt. Can they do so, foreign company? Yes, but CG may have prescribed the rules and the manners, according to that IDR should be offered. Next comes section 391, with regard to application of section 34 to 36 and chapter 20. you know, 34 to 36 you studied in IOPCC, that is with regard to prospectors. So it will applicable as section 34 to 36 with regard to the prospectors, and you know we see in section 38 389 with regard to prospect that all as applicable to foreign company. Chapter 20 IDR, this also applicable, section 376. This is an amendment again. This is the amendment. So in the case of closure of business chapter, as per chapter 22 20, it will applicable as to foreign company also. That is in case they raise the money and not repaid or not redeemed. What is section 376? Section 376 also applicable to in case of IDR. What is section 376? Company incorporated outside India, that is a foreign company, ceases to exist. So that time winding up of company is possible as a unregistered company. So that is a section 376. So this is the amendment part. So this will apply 34 to 36 and chapter 20 will be applicable. Next, moving on to section 392 with regard to the when the provision is not comply, they will have the fine that we discussed earlier. What about the validity of the transaction? That talks about the section 393. Failure to comply with the provision not affects the validity of that contract, dealings and transaction. That means foreign company entered transaction with the other person, so foreign company not complied with the provision. But he can sue the company. So he will get the whatever is liability. Required amount he can recover this person. But at the same time, another case, foreign company, other person not complied. With the provision, he cannot go and make a case against the other company because he is not comply with the provision. So it is always in the favor of the other person because he can make complaint and get into action and get the recovery in case of a damage or loss only if they are complied with the provision. Of course they are, because they are from outside of India, strict regulation will be served. 393, failure to comply with the provision not affects the validity of the contract, deal or transaction. That is section 393. I think we covered almost everything with regard to the foreign company. We started with the from here section 380, documents to be delivered to register by foreign company. That is section 380, documents given, certified copy of charter, statute or a memorandum or and articles or any other instrument that defines the constitution of India. It should be in English language. If it is not in English language, there should be a certified translation should be given in English language. full address of registered or a principal officer, list of director or a secretary of company, name and address of a person resident in India who authorizes to receive the notice, service of prospectus, process, full address, deemed to be place of principal office of the company in India, particulars of the opening, closing place of business in India, earlier occasion, if any, and declaration should be given that none of the directors has been convicted or debarred to formation of company and managing the company in India or abroad. Where to be delivered these documents? Registrar having jurisdiction over New Delhi. This one example given, Chinese company wanted to have business in India. So as a foreign company, they have memorandum in local language. They have to submit that memorandum to the registrar as per section 380, but that has to be translated. So the question is, who will authenticate the translation? So rule 10 says advocate or attorney or a pleader entitled to appear